Wake up. Wake up from the trance.
Hey, Chris here. Reading the book, Evil Plans, Having Fun on the Road to World Domination, a book by Hugh MacLeod, who's a blogger at gapingvoid.com, a cartoonist, and a contemporary of Seth Godin. You know, I'm a huge Seth Godin fan. So I'm reading it, and I came across a passage called This Is It. This Is It, also a great title of a song by Kenny Loggins from a million years ago, but this is a different This Is It. Here's the passage in the book that I was reading, and it spoke to me, so I figured I would speak it to you. Here's what Hugh MacLeod says in the passage or chapter, This Is It. It's easy to tell somebody to get into the zone, that place where work and love are unified. Much harder to live it, but fight like hell to get there, regardless, every friggin' day, or else you'll never make it. Mark Morris is a famous contemporary dancer and choreographer in New York. His dance company, the Mark Morris Dance Group, tours the world, has its own large modern building in Brooklyn, not the usual New York rented loft space, and has its own school for children. He's successful, cutting edge, critically acclaimed, and really, really good at what he does. I saw him being interviewed on television one evening several years ago. He said something that really stayed with me, something I will always remember when I need a little jolt of inspiration. To paraphrase, when new dancers come to work for my company, I tell them, this is it. In other words, this is as good as it gets. They're here to do their life's best work, or at least part of it. They're not here just to fill time and pay the bills until what they really want to do finally comes along. And I only work with dancers who can sincerely operate at that level. The people sincerely doing their life's work here and now. Not dancers waiting for their lives to one day begin. That's good stuff. Hugh writes on, I confess, I was doing anything but my life's best work at that time. I was holding down a crappy hack advertising job. Luckily, times have changed since then, but at the time it was killing me, to be honest. Thank God they laid me off eventually. We've all been there. You know you're capable of doing great things, being in the zone, but every external marker out there indicates otherwise, that you'll never get to do your life's best work that you're capable of, that your career will be nothing but drudgery and abuse in exchange for what seems an increasingly meager paycheck. Yeah, it's a painful place to be, but it doesn't last forever, not if you don't give up, not if you don't succumb to all the overpriced, treadmill-type external markers of success. Fancy houses, cars, schools, vacations, and stuff you can't really afford that you don't really need nearly as much as the guy in the next cubicle says you do. This is it. Fight like hell. Hugh MacLeod. Evil Plans. Good book. Check it out. Check out his website, gapingvoid.com. Catch you later.